Marsh is a junkie. What do you think would happen if Marty Jackson was found supplying her habit? I'd say he'd be sacked and jailed, wouldn't you?
It's best to forget him. Why do they do it, Reed? Why do they want to rape you?
I don't know.
All the same, murdering bloody rapists.
Did he tell you what he was in for?
No, but Vicky said that he was...
Vicky got it wrong.
What do you mean?
Well, now, don't go getting your hopes up, but I think you at least ought to ask him yourself.
But if it's true, I don't want to be with him on my own again.
I'll go with him.
Oh, I nearly forgot. Mother said to give you her new post office box number. I'll write it down for you. Well, you should have no reason for not writing now.
Right.
I put the word out. You're finished. No one's going to give you a job, not in this city. And it doesn't take long for word to get interstate.
No one takes the word of a crim.
Have fun finding out. Are you sure I can't give you a reference?
Aren't you ever going to forgive me?
There's nothing to forgive. You taught me real well, Mum. Now I look out for number one, so why don't you just nick off and let me get on with it?
Psychiatrist, will ya?
Well, what would you care for anyway, huh?
Because we're mates.
Well, up yours too, you stinking bitch! I was only trying to help!
Yeah, well, nobody asked you. Why don't you just shut up and get on with it? You're giving me a gutache.
Bugger ya! You can get someone else to take it out on. I'm not your stinking whipping boy!
What's up?
Plenty, according to Lurch.
Lurch?
Alice.
Yeah, really blew that one. Leastways, that Sheila did bursting in like
well,
that.
Well, believe it or not, she wants to hear your side of it.
Oh, that's great. More than I deserve.
You'd know.
I mean, she's really something, Alice. Still willing to talk to me,
she
eh?
She took some convincing, but she wants to believe you, so I hope your story doesn't let her down too much.
Well, I was trying to tell her, but... Well, it still doesn't sit easy with me, even after all these
years. Save it for Lurch, fella. Spider will fix you both up after lunch, okay?
Connor.
G'day there, Mr. Adams. How's your dating going?
What are you doing in this area?
Sticky beacon.
Loss of shop privileges for 2 days.
Yeah. Well, when are we going to find out what's going on down there?
When the governor's good and ready. Now move.
There you go.
Connor! So what was she after?
Fixing it up for me to see Alice again?
Yeah, me, darling.
Shut up, you stupid bastard.
I tell you, his taste's all in his mouth. You go for that ugly Sheila.
Since when have you been choosy, huh?
Oh, the last one we got. She was a real looker.
Yeah, well, I reckon we've got a chance to get another one.
What, with that horse?
Uh-huh. She's yours. I like him tall and blonde.
Joan Ferguson.
Oh, Miss Ferguson. Damien Mortimer from Hampton Limited.
Yes, Mr. Mortimer.
Look, I'm sorry we couldn't get back to you earlier. We had a long list of applicants, but I'm happy to say that you're our choice for the position.
Oh, that's
wonderful.
We think so too, Miss Ferguson.
You're just what we need here at Hampton.
Tell me, Mr. Mortimer, Hampton Limited, is that in any way connected with Centaur Security?
No, we're an independent company.
Miss Beecham is managing director there.
I'm sorry, I don't know her. Look, Miss Ferguson, you're not having second thoughts, are you?
Because if so, we'd need to know immediately.
Oh, no, not at all. I want the position. It's just that I almost took a job with them, but I'm glad I changed my mind.
To our advantage, Miss Ferguson.
Look, is it possible for you to come in today to discuss salary and conditions?
Oh, yes. Say 2 o'clock?
2 o'clock would be fine.
Thank you. I'll see you then. Bye.
You're going to arrange it for Lurch and Harry to get together this hour, for $10.
For nothing.
I'll get stuffed. You took Lurch's money yesterday afternoon, knowing what that guy was in for. You're going to make up for it, right?
Okay. Hey, when you see him, can you ask him if he raped her before he killed her or the other way around?
Bitch! Back off. You won't get to see Harry if you're in the pound.
Yeah. I reckon I'm making a big mistake seeing him again, Reet.
I don't think so. I reckon whatever he's in for, he's paid for. Still paying for it by the sound of it.
Yeah? Connor thinks her feet don't stink since she got back in as top dog. Well, I'm going to make him sorry she put the hands on. Hey, where are you going? Anywhere but here. I've had it with you and your guts.
David, hang on a minute.
What?
I've been laying it on you, haven't I? It's a bloody understatement of the year.
Yeah, well, quit sulking, will you, and sit down?
Is that an apology?
Yeah, okay. Come on, get back here. We've got to work out your own bloody contraband business before we get started. Well, it better be 50-50.
Mel, come and get it.
Oh, Mrs. Reynolds, I'm going to come and have lunch with us again because I'll go your Harveys and the leftovers.
Thank you, Mel, but I've already eaten.
Just a minute, Jones. Mrs. Reynolds has an announcement.
Oh, geez, what are we done now? It's not we, Jenkins, it's you.
What have I done?
You and Connors have been more than curious about the extension down at C Block. I've decided to put you out of your misery.
Our own flat with two separate bedrooms. So whoever earns 20 points will have the honour of being the first to use it.
Yeah, I can. Shut up, you.
Well, I want to get this straight. We can earn 1 point a day and we've got 5 to start with, right?
That's right.
Oh, geez, it must be there 2 weeks.
There's more yet.
I just want you to remember that although you can win points for good behaviour, you can also lose points for bad behaviour.
Oh, I knew there'd be a catch.
Button up, Simpson.
So it'll be up to you and you alone to earn this taste of freedom.
You mean we get passed into town and everything?
Sorry, Tucker, not that much freedom. But the flat does open out into the garden, so during the day you'll be able to come and go to the grounds as you wish without an escorting officer.
Well, even if we've got mates and family with us.
That's right. So work hard for it. I know you'll be as pleased as I am that we've managed to get this off the ground. All right, ladies, that's all, thank you.
Hey, I'll be able to have my sister and her kids to visit me when I'm in there.
Only if I'm not having a session with a conqueror.
Hey, and I can make a break from the flat.
Brumby,
maybe I better not see Harry this afternoon. I might lose some points.
Oh, about it's already teed up. Anyway, it'd be worth it just to see the look on your face.
Hey, you reckon he's an okay fella?
Oh, you'll have to work that out for yourself.
Do you reckon Renault will let us have blokes in overnight at this new flat?
Oh.
Susie, Jim here. Ferguson's at Hampton Limited right now. Got the job this morning. Come to talk to a Damien Mortimer. What's that? No worries. Tell Willie I'll see you later.
G'day, Harry. What'll you have?
Just some tobacco, thanks. What time?
3 o'clock, same place.
Tobacco, gotcha.
Sign here.
And some papers too. Oh, that's okay.
Yeah, she's okay, but I reckon you ought to get your eyes checked.
Yeah, thanks.
So, how's it going, gorgeous?
What'll you have?
Oh, a chance with Alice and the bikie. And some drinking chocolate.
Get lost, Wilson, they wouldn't be interested.
Don't forget the milk powder.
Doesn't stop us, like we'll go and sit off old Harry and give him a treat, eh?
Only canned milk. Forget it, unless you can come up with $20.
I've never played my life, love. But,
2 cans, then.
You will, if you don't get us what we want.
And what makes you think that?
Well, I saw it goes outside of the fence. Now, you don't come to the party. None of my blokes will touch a black mark.
Hey, what about some sugar?
Yeah, sugar. So, how about it?
Connors would kill me.
No way. worries. We'll fix this and cop any flag.
And sign this bloody thing off, lad. Pencil's looking sus.
Meet you at the gate at 3 o'clock.
I haven't said I would.
Oh, you will. If you want to stay in business.
See you, gorgeous.
What do you want?
And this is my domain.
Oh, you certainly work in pleasant surroundings.
Well, we like it.
Thank you.
You've got your job description there, haven't you? Yes, good. Well, just the run-of-the-mill duties of any office manager, really.
Oh, I don't see any problems.
Minimising running costs, that'll be your main objective. Oh, excuse me. Mortimer? Yes? Yes? Of course. I understand. Yes, thank you.
Problems?
There could have been, Miss Ferguson, but fortunately there's still some honesty in this world. You told me you turned down a job with Central.
Well, that's not quite true.
It's far from true, Miss Ferguson. The truth is that they dispensed with your services and you were foolish enough to ask for a reference. Well, that was it. They just phoned it through.
Any point in denying that I asked for a reference? I mean, why would I...
Sorry, I think it would be best if you just left.
Right. Why don't you try thinking for yourself sometime? Or do you leave all that to your secretary?
Okay, you start up the other end and we'll meet you in a minute. I'm going to ring Tommy first, tell him about the flat.
He'll get school.
No, he won't. He's always wagging.
Leave it till after, Mill. If you get caught, you'll be on a charge.
I won't get caught. I'll put up the invisible screen.
See? I'll keep knit. You just hurry it up, okay?
Okay.
Oh, come on.
What numbers do I do?
Oh, Mill, don't you know what number he's got?
No.
Oh, come on, we'll look it up. What's his name again?
Tommy Kipman.
Do you know his father's name?
No.
Well, what suburb? Oh, come on, Mel, we'll both get had at this rate.
Mel something.
Melton?
Yeah.
Okay, here's one. T.J. Kipman. Now dial carefully. Maybe his father's called Thomas too. Now, don't talk too long, okay?
Let's ring him.
G'day, Tommy!
Tommy, g'day, it's me, Mo. Guess what? Kath and me are gonna escape. I'm not meant to tell anybody.
Hi, what are you two doing here?
Could ask the same question about you, mate.
Heavy bastard.
What a picture, eh? Him and Alice, my darling.
Give me a time, but I'll go wait for the sleaze.
Look, I'm really sorry about this, mate.
Oh.
Oi! None of that either. Come on, you bitch, you're late.
Shut up, you're lucky I showed.
Not as lucky as you, sweetheart. You know bloody well you get a lot of business through us.
I'm getting back at Connor's and that's the only reason, and don't forget it.
Well, you wanted it to look good, sweetheart, didn't you, huh? And I'm an expert.
Jeez, I hope you're right, Rape.
Thought you had a gut feeling about him yourself.
Yeah, rape and murder, that's pretty heavy stuff.
Yeah.
He seems such a nice fella. Someone's coming.
Take it easy, love.
What's she like that for? Where's Harry?
Change of plans. I knew there was two of you, so I came instead. Harry couldn't have both of you, huh?
Nice cosy party for the four of us, eh?
You haven't done your sums right, chum. I count the five of us.
Yeah? Well, one of us will be watching. Unless, you want to fix two of them up, Billy.
You've got to be joking. I should have been on a special diet for this one.
A bit fond of yourself, aren't you?
Well, hang on, Luke. Someone's got to love him. I mean, look at him.
Shut up!
Well, don't you love him when he gets mad?
Yeah, shut up, Slocks. We're wasting time.
Might be. I've lost interest.
Oh, I didn't. Spat the dummy, have you?
Who cares? He wasn't getting nothing anyway.
Well, don't bet on it, sweetheart. We didn't come for a cup of tea.
It's all right, lover. Calm down. I know what you came for.
Yeah, well, they can bugger off as far as I'm concerned.
Listen, dog face.
Nasty? I might have to send you home. That'd be a real waste, wouldn't it?
Hey, you gotta be joking. You're not gonna do anything with them.
You bet I am.
What?
I've had my eyes on this hunk ever since the girl stripped him off in the yard. He's got some nice equipment. Be a pity to waste it, wouldn't it?
Back off, bird. I make the moves, huh?
Don't worry, lovey, you're gonna be moving, all right.
Come on, Reed.
Now, hang on, Lurch. You can do what you want, but you're not gonna spoil my fun.
Yeah, but he was the one who gave Lisa a hard time.
Okay, so now it's my turn to have fun with him. I'm gonna show you how it's done, Spunk.
You're gonna show stud.
You bet, and Lurch is gonna do the same for you.
Oh, you're off your face.
You remember that thing you wanted to do to Roddy Boy? Why not do it to Billy Boy?
Oh, yeah. Come here, twerp. Right.
Oh, yes. Could I speak to Mr. Daly, please? Mr. Daly, my name is Joan Ferguson. I'm ringing with regard to the position you advertised this morning. But it can't be filled already. I see. Thank you.
Have a ringside seat at a rate there for a minute. Stinking mongrel. If you've done anything to Harry, I'll do him over myself.
Yeah, I'll help you.
If I find out you had anything to do with this spider, you'll be using your boots because your fingers will be mashed.
I told you, they tricked me.
Yeah, well, what's to say it wasn't Harry who did the dirty on you, hey?
They say he did.
No, but it's on the cards. Probably got paid to swap.
Is that right? Maybe he did. Bastards. You're all bastards.
Hang on. Look at the story from Harry.
I'd probably lie through his teeth.
Shut up, Simpson.
You're not going to let him get away with it.
Oh, not bloody likely. We'll take a leaf out of Reno's book. Let the punishment fit the crime.
Yeah.
Cut him.
Harry, too, if you let him.
We don't need to be that drastic, Lurch. But they're sure going to be sorry they ever tangled with us.
Yes, this is Joan Ferguson speaking. Get me through to the minister, please. I see. Will you tell him I called the minute he gets back? Joan Ferguson. Thank you.
So you believe they jumped me now?
Oh, quick, Grizzling, will you?
Keep it.
Oh, God.
Oh, geez, you okay?
Yeah, nothing. A couple of aspirins won't fix. Jeez, I'm glad they didn't hurt you, Alice.
Should have known you had nothing to do with it.
Oh, I can't blame you for thinking I did. Look, while we're on the subject, the reason...
Sorry, but you're going to have your chat some other time. We've got a couple of problems on it.
Oh, jeez, Reed, let me take a minute.
A minute, big bucket. We've got to get those mongrels out of the library.
What, safe territory? They'll open the place for another 20 minutes. Come on, Reed, it's real important to me.
You two, Sheila, shift
heads, rack off, you.
We'll all rack off. Now move.
Just one more thing.
Make it fast.
Well, I don't know how true it is, but word is they're the blokes that raped that Sheila in solitary.
Out of fact. Well, it sort of changes our plans for those boys.
Yeah, we're running out of time. 20 minutes, remember?
Well, me and some of the boys can make sure they won't be missed till lockup. Give you enough time?
Yeah, come on, Lurch.
I've got to know the truth about you, Harry. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, sure, Alice.
Come on, Lurch!
Jeez, you okay?
Yeah. Check the corridor, spider.
Oh, there's no one there.
Check the bloody corridor.
Okay, clear. Satisfied?
Good. Get their gags off, Lurch.
You sure? What if they start yelling?
They won't. They start yelling, they'll bring the screws down on us. Then they'll have to explain what they're doing in H Block.
Fair enough.
That isn't enough.
Go easy, will you?
It's going to happen every time they open their mouth.
We're only looking for a bit of fun.
Oh, there'll be plenty of fun, Billy. In fact, more fun than Lurch and me will be able to handle. So we'll be calling the other girls in.
You stinking bitch.
Got the message, or do you want to have another go?
Hey, look, I don't want to spoil your fun, but we're really pushing our luck here.
She's right, Rita. Three of us missing it, Rick. It's too many.
Bugger off, spider, cover for us.
How am I supposed to
of that.
The same way you do every other slimy thing in this dump. Well, just do it.
Well, we missed two Connors.
No way. Harry's fixing that.
Yeah, I don't think your mates like you. Harry tells us you won't be missed till lockup.
Pass. Now shut up, stud. Why are you doing this?
Lorelei Wilkinson.
We had to.
Shut up.
You're gonna kill us, you stupid bastard. Craven made us do it. You know what he was like? He made us.
He opened all the gates for you, did he? Pushed you in the cell, tied Laurie up. He did all that, did he?
What are you gonna do?
Gag him. I don't know what we're gonna do yet. I know what Lurch wants to do. She wants to take a razor blade and make sure you never look at another woman again. We're gonna be fair about this. We're gonna see what the other girls think.
Rest of you. But I'm not shooting first and asking questions later.
Yeah, well, you can quit worrying because they owned up.
Oh, it wasn't their fault, of course. Craven made them do.
Oh, yeah, I bet they really hated it too.
So I think we're all agreed that something's got to be done, right?
Right.
Screw.
I don't know what's the matter with you, Sheilas. It's easy. 5 points a day, right?
Good heavens, what are you girls up to? We could hear you in the staff room.
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Pringle, just trying to bash some sense into some of these Sheilas. I still haven't worked out the point system for the flat.
But it was explained to them fully.
Yeah, I know, but you've got to draw pictures for some of them. Barney Bear earns 1 point a day. Oh, yeah.
Well, if Barney could be a lot quieter, perhaps he would earn a lot more points.
Yes, Mrs. Pringle.
5 points to start with, right? You get 1 point for each day of the week. That gives you 12 points at the end.
She's gone.
Okay, so what are we going to do? And we're not killing them.
Why not?
Yeah, I would.
Because it's too fast. Laurie's got to live with that rape for the rest of her life.
Yeah.
So whatever we do to them's got to have the same effect.
What's wrong with Lurch's suggestion?
Yeah, cut them.
Hands up those who agree. Right. Now, we've really got some planning to do.
Had a right fun.
Got it? Of course I have. Still reckon I ought to get paid for it.
Yeah, well, you're not going as a shadow.
Who's going to do it?
Well, draw straws.
I'm sorry, but I don't think I could.
Fair enough. Anyone else?
Sorry.
Don't be. It's not going to be pretty. Anyone else doesn't want to draw a straw, I suggest they leave now. All right, here's the story. Everyone gets a match. Coloured match draws the job, okay? Any questions?
Hope you big tough guys haven't been getting lonely in the dark. We would have been here sooner, but we've been busy. All the girls had a lot to say about what we're going to do to you.
Mm.
This ain't the complaints department. I thought you would have been flattered. Well, those pretty girls taking a big interest in you? You like pretty girls, don't you? Laurie got hurt real bad. And if there's one thing we do around here, it's even the score. She gets hurt, you get hurt. That's easy enough to understand, isn't it? Oh, don't worry. You're going to walk out here. But it's going to be a long time before you're walking anything like you used to. We're going to take a few souvenirs. Something to remember you by. We want to make sure there are going to be no more little studs and little billies running around hurting people. Get it? Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry, it's not time yet. You know, we all had to draw straws. It was the only fair way, because everyone wants to do it. Cheer you up. Everyone's going to be paying you a visit before it happens. Whoever it is, just might knock you senseless before they do it. But I wouldn't expect any favors. Mr. Adams!
I hear Marty Jackson isn't the saint he makes out to be.
Yeah?
It's pretty meaty information. I'll trade you for getting in contraband.
I told you I couldn't.
You want to keep Spider quiet, don't you?
This information, does it involve Wentworth?
Particularly one of its inmates.
Who, Connors? No. Wait a minute, Marsh! All those cozy little chats they have.
Very clever. But it's not just their friendship. She's back on heroin and he's supplying it.
You better have proof.
I heard Marsh bragging she was getting more in this afternoon. Why not check it out yourself?
Jackson.
Don't forget, you owe me.
I won't. As long as it's not a trick to make a fool out of me. Are you sure?
She's got him running after her like a lovesick puppy.
I'll look into it.
Not every day I get a chance to help a damsel in distress.
Thank you.
Okay.
I know. Have you got any of those chocolates left from Spider's cache?
Oh, no, Kat. They're real bad. Reed ate some of them. She got real sick. I got one left, but I'm not game to touch it.
Show me.
Okay, it's real bad.
Oh, now, come on. Unless it's got a green wrapper on it, it's going to be all right. See?
It's yellow.
So that means there's nothing to worry about. That's a good present for Spike.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to her right now.
Don't you eat it, Mo.
G'day, Mo. Brumby's just gone to the toilet. She'll be back in a sec.
Oh, yeah, okay. Guess what?
What?
I got a present for you for helping me ring Tommy.
Oh, no, you don't have to do that.
Oh, yeah, I wanted that. Only at Chucky, see? Not too much.
Okay. Thanks, that's really nice of you.
I'm jamming it now so we know it's in the middle. I hope it's strawberry because they're my favourites.
Well, if it is, we'll go halves.
Oh, couldn't do that.
No, I insist.
All right, then. I need your size that don't hurt your feelings.
It's coffee, I think.
Oh, yuck! I hate them.
Well, I think it's delicious. Can't smell that. Very thoughtful of you.
Yeah. See, I'm swapping these. This one's real good. Captain Marvel almost gets married, but the lady turns out to be a baddie in disguise.
Poor Captain Marvel.
Oh, no, he was real lucky, because she was from this gang and she was going to discover his weakness and overpower him. And hey, hang on, I'll show you. Oh,
it's just looking very
good. What for?
I need some electrical flex. Do you think you can find some for me?
What's the matter? Mill won't play black boy for you no more.
It's for our escape.
Oh, that's different. No worries.
Fine.
Here he is. Zapping and bamming everyone. What's the matter?
That chocolate.
The chocolate! The chocolate! Quick, it's poison! The chocolate! The chocolate is poison, Kat.
Calm down, stop it.
But she's sick and it's my fault.
It's silly. It could be anything. Now let's go and check before we put everyone in a panic.
But quick, she might die. Spike, you're not dying, are you?
Shh. She's asleep.
See, I told you not to worry. You reckon?
I think she's probably coming down with the flu or something. She just needs a good rest. Now, come on, let's go and eat.
Oh, I'm glad it wasn't a chockey, because I would have banged Spider right out the window.
Might be me. Might not. You'll find out.
Yes, no problems. I've got it right here. Yes, bye. Oh, these eternal order forms, I do hate them.
I'd give you a hand, except I'm due back on round soon.
Oh, don't worry. I wouldn't wish it on my best friend. I'm sorry, I didn't mean that the way it sounded.
Oh, Mrs. Jackson,
if you want. Oh, good.
Glad for your life. So, how did the girls take to the news about the new flat?
Oh, it's going to be a great success. They're very excited about it.
What's
this? Let me see.
It's evidence.
What is it?
I'd like you to check it, Mrs. Pringle, though I'd say at a glance it's heroin.
Oh,
that's impossible.
Obviously, it's not.
Marty, I don't understand.
You bastard! You planted that while you were checking my...
I beg your pardon.
Don't bother,
Marty, Alice. Marty, we are going to have to take this through to Mrs. Reynolds now.
Good. She'll sort it out.
I did not put that package in your bag, Jackson. I resent the inference that I did.
Well, all I know is that it wasn't there when I left home. God almighty, you know damn well I wouldn't have anything to do with this stuff.
I am surprised, I must admit, but stranger things have happened.
Well, you don't believe it?
I was only doing my duty.
Oh, no. Bullsh!
Now, I'm not saying who's guilty and who isn't until I have all the facts. And even then, it'll be up to the board.
I'm sorry, look, I didn't know the stuff was there, so naturally I...
Joyce, could Adams have had a chance to slip the package into the bag?
Oh, well, I don't know, really. He was right at my elbow.
See.
You say you need all the facts, Mrs. Reynolds.
You have something to add?
Well, it's only hearsay, of course, but I overheard the women saying that Marsh was back on heroin and being supplied by Mr. Jackson. That's why I took particular care in searching his bag.
I have no other choice but to place you on suspension immediately. Pending a full investigation, you will wait in the staff room until the police have a full statement. That'll be all.
Come on, Marty. I was the only one handling business in this place.
No, why?
Spike's as high as a bloody kite and there's only one bitch hungry enough to sell her skag.
Maxwell, I thought she was off.
Oh, well, it's a junkie, always a junkie, and you better set Maxwell straight.
Do more than that, she's behind it.
Here, read this. It's got goodies and baddies in it.
Oh, Tar, I left some comics on your bed.
Hey, great. Just what the doctor ordered. Be a bit more careful, can't you?
Was she, right?
So when's that happening? As soon as I can short the alarm system, you'll have plenty of warning, don't worry.
You better go and check on your mate, Brumby. She's not feeling too well.
She's sick. What's up with her? Have you got something to tell us, Max?
I think she's probably got the flu.
Flu-ty bug.
Okay?
Spaced out. Surprise, Max.
You're kidding, you bitch.
What do you mean, spaced out?
Oh, it's a kite, Maxwell. Are you up to your old tricks?
Had a good dose of the hard stuff and you gave it to her, you bitch.
Don't you cry, that's bad. I'll bang you right in the ground.
Go and wait for me in the rec room, please.
Okay.
Come on, Maxwell, talk.
I know nothing about it, honestly.
Oh, yeah, I bet.
Who else would sell her that crap? I'd say someone who was trying to cause more trouble for me, Simpson.
Don't go try pushing it onto me,
oh, shut up, you two. We'll get the story from Spike, and if you are behind
it... Oh, come on, you know she did it.
Stinking. Rot. Riches. Let's get the bloody hell out of here. Listen, we're not going anywhere. Those bitches are going to be sorry they ever laid a hand on me.
Oh, come on, Spike. Well, she didn't shoot it.
Well, how'd she take it?
Okay. What do you think? She's up to her eyeballs in smack.
It's got to be Maxwell, Reed.
Kill that bitch. Stay out of it, Simpson.
Out of the way, you three.
Go.
Just to tell me what guy I reckon, Mrs.
Reynolds.
Connors, do you know anything about this?
Oh, no, but I'll be looking into it, believe me.
So will I. Now, all of you out. Jenkins?
Oh, please, can I stay now?
Out. Help us get her onto the bed. Mrs. Pringle, get sister down here straight away.
Right. Would you get out of the way?
I'm going to front Maxwell.
Oh, now we're getting somewhere.
Right.
Oh, come on, it's got to be Maxwell. I'm not saying it isn't, but there's got to be a full-scale search for drugs, right? Oh, God, we got those. So let's take care of them. You make sure the screws don't go near the equipment room and tell Lurch to meet me there.
Yes, this is Kath Maxwell, and I have to talk first. Tell Willis the job's done, and I want out of here tomorrow. It's done. If you don't believe me, check. All right, I'll ring first thing tomorrow for the details.
Get it tied up.
She's out cold, mate. You reckon she's all right?
She better be. I wanted to suffer.
I was hoping you'd show.
Save your breath. I'm not retracting my statement. It was the truth.
You planted that stuff. Now, I don't know why you've got it in for me, mate, but this is low even for you.
I'm telling you, I found the stuff in your bag and nothing you say can change it. You're the low one, Jackson. Heroin. God, I thought you were straight down the line.
Hell, you didn't plan it, did you?
You know damn well I didn't. Now, if you don't mind, I've got some work to
I
do.
Swear I didn't know that stuff was
Tell
in there.
The police. I'm on duty.
What do you reckon, Brumby?
Huh? Oh, dad, a girl. Oh, I couldn't have got a bit of fire.
And this one's for you, Bully. Hey, what's the matter? Huh? Boy, there's nothing to be scared of. Bully can be real gentle. Huh? You know what I'm gonna do with this? If they don't play the game right? So what do you reckon, Blondie?
Settle down, mate.
Huh? Oh, don't worry. Not gonna put her out of action until I've had me fun.
Ree?
Kill her! And we're stuck here without the key! And she can get the key from Spider! She can get it from Spider, mate!
Go check the corridor.
I'm coming!
Jones? And just where do you think you're going?
I thought I heard something down there.
All right, I'll check it out later. Go on, off you go, but back. Now, Merle.
Yeah, okay.
Is that your mess?
Yeah, it's my ball. I was playing footy.
Well, get rid of it, eh? Now, off you go, back to the rec room.
Wait, there's someone coming.
Quick, get them out of sight. Control. Could be right now for hours.
I reckon we should get the hell out of here.
Oh, not bloody likely. Come here, Blondie. Go for Billy, stupid bastard. Go!
The sun and rain are prisoners too.